Welcome to Outdoor Cast Iron Cooking. I'm Dean, I'm your host. Today we're coming to you from Ocean Cove, California. We're here at the NorCal Teardroppers third annual teardrop gathering at Ocean Cove. We're gonna have some fun. We've met some new friends. Today we're doing pizza in the Dutch oven.
This is Outdoor Cast Iron Cooking. Today we're going to be showing you how to make Dutch oven pizzas here in Ocean Cove, California. We're going to do two varieties today because sometimes people might be watching their weight or their calories. Down in front of me here I have some of the ingredients. We've got our pizza dough and I have it wrapped right now in parchment paper. We have that made up. We have different kinds of cheeses, some low-fat mozzarella, some of the mozzarella mild, cheddar together. We're going to do one pizza that's going to have pepperoni, that's turkey pepperoni and Canadian style bacon, 70% less fat. Our second pizza is going to have original pepperoni, bacon, sausage, salami, Canadian bacon. We also personally prefer a pizza squeeze, but you can use your own. Also for convenience, decide if you want to have your dough, which you can make out, or sometimes you can buy the mixes.
First thing we need to do is brown up some bacon and sausage for this carnivore pizza. So what I've done, I've taken and dumped about a half a chimney of briquettes on my cooking table. And I've preheated my oiled Dutch oven up.
Ah, what's great about outdoor cooking, the sights, the smells, and now those sounds. You can do sausage that's ground sausage, crumbled. We're gonna do links today and after they're cooked, we'll cut them up.
We've browned the sausage and bacon, so now we're ready to build a pizza. I've got my dough rolled out. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna trim it. Okay, we're going to sprinkle some cornmeal on here. Hearth-type pizza parlors use cornmeal to keep their crust from sticking, and it imparts a really nice flavor into the dough, and I kind of like that, so I'm going to put that on my dough. I'm going to put my round piece of parchment paper on here. Now I'm going to flip this over, lay this down in the oven, and build my pizza. Okay, I'm going to take the pizza skin, I'm going to lay it down in the oven, and what I did is I pre-cut this parchment paper round a little bit bigger than what my pizza skin is, and then the pizza skin itself is a little bit bigger diameter than the bottom of the Dutch oven, and I'm going to just form a little lip there, and I like this because this is kind of making a tray. It's going to hold lots of ingredients. Okay, we're going to lay down some pizza squeeze here. I'm going to spread this around, make a nice coating on the crust. We're going to add some cheese now. We're going to put about a pound of mozzarella down. Get that nice and spread out.
The beauty of the parchment paper is that any overflow, it's making for easy cleanup. We have some full slices of Canadian bacon going above the layer of cheese, and we'll follow that with salami, dry cut, and original pepperoni. This is going to be the carnivore. We'll also add some sausage. It's already been cut up, crumbled, and bacon as well.
Lay down some bacon. Now, before I put my other ingredients on, I need to add just a little bit of cheese, which will help stitch the ingredients together and help hold everything in place.
As you assemble each layer, such as we now have done with the salami, sprinkle some cheese on the top again to hold the layers together. If you're a cheese eater, add more, but you just kind of want to keep assembling the items and putting them on together. Next on, we're going to put the pepperoni and sausage. All right, the pepperoni gone down and the sausage is coming on top of it. Again, you can decide if you want to have crumbled sausage and use that, or if you decide you want to have link sausage as we did today, cut it up, crumble it up when you're done.
Okay, now I'm just putting a final little sprinkling of cheese, got some cheddar in there to add some color. I just want to put enough to hold the toppings in place. Most of the cheese is underneath on top of the sauce. We're ready to bake this.
Okay, I've got 25 coals on the bottom. I've got 40 coals on top. We're going to cook this thing hot and fast with one rotation. We're going to cook this for about 18 minutes with one rotation at midpoint.
This is a 14-inch oven.
Okay, it's time to take the pizza out of the oven.
Here's where the parchment paper is the real handy trick to use. Now you notice there's not a lot of grease that congealed on here. One of the things I did was when the sausage and the bacon came out, I did kind of blotter it with a piece of paper towel. If it's too much oil on top for you, you can do the same thing, but that looks like one great carnivore pizza.
Our new friends, Rick and Chris, made these ribs. They look absolutely awesome. There's the carnivore. Here's some fried rice made by Teresa, Dan's wife, the director and co-director of the NorCal Tearjerkers chapter. Okay, let's go meet them. Okay, this is Rick, and this is Chris. They're our new friends. It's our first teardrop gathering.
And this pizza's delicious.
Say hi, Chris. You're on YouTube.
Hello. This is fun.
Thank you for the pizza. Very good.
This is Dan. He's the director of the NorCal Tearjerkers chapter. There's Teresa. And here's Joni's health-conscious, low-fat pepperoni pizza.